Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. User Silver Magnolia sent me a link to this very interesting article here from Russia Beyond on how the Ruskies can turn sludge into gold. Let's explore! Yes, indeed, these Russian metallurgical Rumpelstiltskins have pioneered an industrial process that extracts silver, gold, selenium, tellurium, and other precious metals following the refinement of copper ore. This process is so revolutionary that it has been officially recognized in London. Well, what's so special about London to recognize? A city recognizes this process? That confuses me a bit, but regardless, the black sludge that accumulates at the bottom of the electrolysis bath in this factory is literally worth its weight in gold because of it's comprised of byproducts from the industrial process by which copper is obtained from copper ore. These byproducts include gold, silver, and rare elements such as selenium and tellurium, as well as a considerable part of the Mendeleev table. Uralkotromed, a process facility located not far from Yekaterinburg, about 17 kilometers east of Moscow, has developed extraordinary expertise in processing these tailings, which is the sludge's technical name, in order to extract the valuable components. Gold and silver bars have been produced here since 1997. Here we see a photograph of them actually doing their thing. In Russia, precious metals have been extracted from different compounds using chemical processes since the 18th century. Pretty impressive. Initially, the refining process has the exclusive right of the Moscow and St. Petersburg mints. The technology has been continually improved and passed on to various processing plants. Today, Russia has 10 such plants that utilize these techniques. And Uralkotromed, I'm pronouncing that wrong, I'm sure, accounts for around 3.5% of gold bar production, as well as 25.2% of the silver on the Russian market. So that is a pretty big share. This amounts to more than 10 tons of gold and over 200 tons of silver each year. All this output is a byproduct of copper production. So talk about alchemy. It uses the power of fire, as you can see in this photograph here. Before the precious bars can be produced from the black sludge, the latter needs to be processed in various ways. First, it needs to be sent down a special pipeline to another production facility where it is treated with sulfuric acid and baked in order to remove any volatile compound. Next, it's sent on its way for the complex stage of smelting. The result is a gold alloy, or doré, from the French word meaning golden or gilded. Chemical reactions are used to break it down further, and the gold will settle with a small amount of impurities. Pure gold powder is subsequently obtained, while the silver remains in solution. Next, it's purified and sent for electrolysis, a process whereby pure silver crystals are deposited on cathode plates. Look at that. Pretty amazing. The further fate of the particles of precious metal is identified, and they're sent to the furnace to be re-smelted. The incandescent metal is then poured into cast iron molds. The furnace temperature for re-smelting gold reaches 1100 degrees Celsius, while for silver the required temperature is a little over 900 Celsius. Interesting. The workers are protected against burns in the effects of that heat by special fire-resistant clothing, gloves, and boots. To know how much metal to pour into the mold, a guide mark is drawn inside with chalk. Then the mold is treated with a graphite mixture to prevent the gold and silver from sticking to it. As soon as the bar cools, it's removed with tongs, cooled under cold water, and wiped with a cloth without allowing the water to dry and leave stains. The whole process takes just 5 minutes, and then the still warm, freshly smelted bar can be picked up with one's hands. Look at that. You have to be careful, however. While a gold bar may seem small, it has the weight of an average size holiday suitcase, Around 12 kilograms, a bar of silver weighs about 30 kilograms. For this reason, they're very difficult to pick up off the table. And even if you manage, you must be careful not to drop it and damage such a precious object or your foot. A gold bar is worth more than $500,000 and a silver one more than 15 grand. To be suitable for dispatch to the customer, they must be free from scratches and chips. Look at those poured silver bars. Pretty amazing. Great care is taken at the plant when handling the smelted bars, and after manufacturing, they're brought to the finishing department where each is polished to a bright shine. Shavings from the polishing process are collected with a special sealed vacuum cleaner, which is open once a month in the presence of a team of inspectors. These precious metal particles are returned to the production process. They're again sent for smelting and have to undergo the whole process all over again. So after polishing, the bars are sent to the quality control department where they're weighed and carefully examined. Gold and silver are a bit like honeycomb chocolate in terms of structure, says the control inspector, Irini Savanskova, bent low over a bar and examining every millimeter. I'm checking to see that dirt hasn't lodged on the surface pores. Boy, I wish some mints would take this care when they mint coins. The next step is to apply markings to the bar, which is a job for a strong man because of the necessary details and processing plant's logo, the gold mark, purity, year of production, and the serial number are etched on the bar using a stencil plate, hammer, and punch. If you make a mistake, the bar must be returned to the finishing room, repolished, weighed, and given a new stamp. That's interesting because you would think it would repolish it and would take out some of that indentation. That's interesting. You would think it had to remelt the whole thing. And this is from Tatiana Yefimova, head of the Production Facilities Refining Department. Mistakes happen very rarely. We try to avoid them. And there we can see the finished product there. After the bar is checked, it is wiped with pure alcohol to remove any fingerprints, spot, and dirt. A souvenir photo is taken, and it is carefully wrapped in polythene, placed in a canvas bag sewn at the plant and put in a special container. Then the bars are dispatched to Russian banks from which they can be exported among other destinations. Wow. Pretty cool. There's the packaging process there in that photograph. The precious metals obtained as byproducts of the main production process at Urelkalkinromend have a purity of 99.99%, a purity we're all familiar with here in this community. The high quality of the gold and silver was first recognized in the early 2000s by the London Bullion Market Expert. So in other words, the LBMA, and that's what they talk about in that first paragraph with London. So it's not the city, it's the London Bullion Market Association, who placed the plant on its honorable good delivery list. That's right. 4 9s pure gold, and even 3 9s is considered good delivery. Every 3 years, a processing plant must pass an inspection in order to have this prestigious status reconfirmed. Look at that. Russia has just 5 holders of this mark of distinction, so quality control is taken very seriously. Modern precious metal production has come a long way since the days of the fairy tale Rumpelstiltskin and alchemy. Everything is regulated to the very last detail. So it's a very, very fascinating indeed how this has been utilized. And these bars are just absolutely incredible to see and how this process is done, taking it from the byproduct of other metals, mainly copper in this particular case. But I will say this as well, that, you know, as far as refining in such great detail from sludge, it's not necessarily out of the ordinary. What I think is fascinating is something I posted a video quite some time ago. I may actually revisit it because I just found the story so fascinating. But a university is able to reconstitute and basically siphon out and filter out silver from sewage waste. That's right. So from your sewage waste, silver can be refined and reconstituted. Pretty fascinating. I'm sure they can do that with gold too and other metals. But very interesting indeed. Thanks again so much to Silver Magnolia for sending this along to me, this article. Post your thoughts below about this process and about how Russia turns sludge into gold. We'd like to extend a multitude of gratitude to y'all for taking the time to watch and encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.